Welcome back, my friends. The rivalry has heated up on the Division I level. Central Connecticut and Quinnipiac, they've been playing each other for years. Central dominates the overall series, but lately the Bobcats have gotten the best of the Blue Devils. QU has won six straight, including a 28-point blowout on Wednesday. Take two this afternoon in New Britain. Here's the Blue Devils' Robbie Tasek with an NBA three to give his team the lead early in the first half. But the Quinnipiac Bobcats battle back. James Johnson was red hot and a little lucky, too. Check out the bounce off the rim, off the back of the backboard, and through it goes. 39-33 QU at the half. Second half, the Blue Devils grab the lead. Freshman scoring machine Kyle Vanellis. This kid is something to watch. A few more inches, he'd be playing at a big-time Division I school. Off the Kenny Horton block, Vanellis finishes. He had 27 points, the only Blue Devil player in double figures today. Central had a 59-54 lead, thanks to Kenny Horton, who finished with eight. That was with 6 minutes to go. They had 59 points. They didn't score again. Ike Azatam and Quinnipiac go to work. Azatam had 15 points, 10 rebounds. James Johnson had 20 for Quinnipiac as they get out of New Britain with a 67-59 win. And to compound the loss for Central, Kenny Horton, the reigning NEC Player of the Year, went down hard late in the game with an injured tailbone. Hope he is okay. Quinnipiac now 8-6 in the Northeast Conference, while Central falls to 7-7. Crashing.
John Holt with Eyewitness Sports.
You played without passion, played without emotion. Quite honestly, we deserve what we got. Highlight of the evening when the final horn went off, so we could go to our locker room and mend our wounds.
In one of the more candid press conferences in recent memory, Central Connecticut State basketball coach Howie Dickeman laid into his team after Wednesday's conference road loss at state rival Quinnipiac. Dickeman is convinced his team isn't tough enough this season. They'd get another chance to prove their coach wrong this afternoon, with QU finishing the home-and-home with a trip to New Britain, a deep three ball from Blue Devil senior Robbie Tasek, CCSU, in the lead in the first half. Down the other end, Quinnipiac got paced by 20 points from James Johnson. The leading scorer this afternoon was CCSU freshman Kyle Vanellis, two of his 27 coming here on the one-on-two. QU would bounce back to take a 39-33 lead into halftime. Johnson, good from three. Second half, this long three from Kenny Horton had CCSU up 57-51 with 10 minutes to play. From there, though, the Blue Devils scored just 2 points the rest of the afternoon, hitting just one of their last 20 shots. Frustration? Yes, frustration. Quinnipiac tied it up 59-59, here in this inside bucket for Mike Azatam. Then they got eight more points to go on to the 67-59 win. Their sixth victory in seven games. Central loses for the sixth time in seven games. Horton finished just 3 of 18 shooting and left the game late after taking a hard fall.
We was playing them at home and they just got embarrassed by the lowest. I knew they was gonna come out hard and their fans were gonna be behind them. So we just wanted to watch film and watch the stuff that we had mistakes on, and just wanted to keep getting better.
I said before the game, we play as hard as we can, and that doesn't necessarily mean we'll win the game, but we need to play hard for 40 minutes and see what the outcome happens. And we were good, we were solid, and then we went 1 for 20 in our last shot attempt.